It's theCUBE, coming to you from San Jose, California. Here's your host, Jeff Frick.
Hi, Jeff Frick here with theCUBE. We're on the ground at the Fairmont Hotel in San Jose, California at the Silicon Valley Business Journal Corporate Philanthropy Awards. And we're here getting kind of the scoop, talking to some of the corporations that are giving the money as well as some of the nonprofits that are benefiting from the contributions. So I'm joined next by Anel Aguayo. Did I get it right?
Yeah, almost.
Almost. Get it right.
Aguayo.
I'm sorry. From Rebuilding Together.
Peninsula.
Peninsula version of Rebuilding,
yes.
It, because it's a national organization,
it's
right?
It's national, and we're one of 200 affiliates.
Okay, and it used to be known as Christmas in April back in the day if you were in college, like when I was in college and we were working on houses. So welcome.
Thank you.
So talk a little bit about the Peninsula version of Rebuilding Together.
So our affiliate covers Daly City all the way down to Sunnyvale. We assist low-income homeowners and other nonprofits with free home and facility repairs. We have three core programs. We have our National Rebuilding Day program, which is probably the program you worked on.
Right.
Held the last Saturday in April every year nationally. Everybody works on that day. Then we have our Safe at Home program, which is minor home repair, and it's a year-round program where we tackle minor home repair before it becomes major deferred maintenance. And then we have our Team Build program, which is very similar to National Rebuilding Day, but it's when a company or another organization can have their own special day to do their project and team building experience.
So talk a little bit about the scale. I mean, how many houses do you guys do? You know, how many people get involved? Give us a few of the numbers behind it.
So we just celebrated our 25th anniversary. And so thank you. Over the last 25 years, we have rallied 60,000 volunteers. We have repaired almost 1,700 homes, approximately 400 community facilities. We have replaced or repaired 650 roofs. And we have had about 200 corporations involved.
Wow. So how important is corporate philanthropy to your guys' cause?
It's huge. We National Rebuilding Day and our Team Build program are built on corporate sponsorship models. So we need these corporations. You know, a lot of corporations want to do good work in the neighborhoods they work in.
Right.
And so they come to us or we approach them and say, hey, you know, this is what we do. This is a good team building experience for your organization. Would you like to be involved? And for the most part, a lot of them have buy-in because it's very unique what we offer. You get to hands-on see the change that you're making for a person.
Yeah.
And not many organizations offer that kind of experience.
Yeah, it's very different, right? It's not just giving money to the professionals to go out and do things.
Yeah.
You do have professionals that help and contribute on things that need,
yeah,
professionals. But it's really an opportunity, like you said, for people at a company to come together to do something good beyond just their day job. Talk about the impact that makes at companies, you know, after they finish the day in April. You know, what do they report back to you? You know, what's really the impact?
So a lot of them say that it's a great experience, and everybody can always pinpoint the moment they felt that appreciation for what they were doing. They were happy to be knee deep in dirt, digging a hole. They were happy to be covered in paint because they helped the poor little widow Mary, or they helped little Janie with asthma, you know, be able to return back to her home. So for them, it really impacts them because they're seeing this. They're seeing that the work they're doing hands-on is going to make a significant difference in that person's life.
Yeah, I was on the House Selection Committee back in Philly, and we saw some really scary stuff, as you can imagine. And the woman that we ended up helping was diabetic. She had no legs, and she had a hole in the floor of her kitchen that went down into the basement.
Yeah.
She couldn't get to the bathroom, so somebody put a toilet in the middle of the kitchen, which was, I mean, it was
not ideal.
Not good. She didn't have safety ramps. It was not good. So
and
we went out there, did a whole lot of work. So it is a great organization.
It is.
And so that's super. So I'll give you the last word. How can people contribute? Where should they go?
So you want to go to RebuildingTogetherPeninsula.org. We have a lot of information regarding volunteering, sponsorship, and just getting involved with the organization. You could talk to me, Anel, or you could talk to Carrie or anybody who answers the phone, really, and we're all more than happy to help. We love everybody, so we don't say no to anybody.
Equal opportunity.
We are.
All right. Well, thanks, Anel.
Thank you.
Again, I'm Jeff Frick here on the ground at the Fairmont Hotel in San Jose at the Silicon Valley Business Journal Awards.